Hello students, so today we will start a new exercise self-practice 5C. This is also the addition and subtraction of the algebraic expression. Now see, the first question is subtract. In the last class we have done self-practice 5B, there we have done addition. Now here we will do the subtraction. So the question is what? Subtract. So we have to subtract the algebraic expression. Now question A, 1A, subtract 2X. Subtract 2x from 7x. So understand the meaning. Subtract 2x from 7x. So subtraction means take away, that is a minus. So we have to subtract 2x from 7x. The meaning of this is what? Take away 2x from 7x. So from 7x, so the number what is written after from, so the number which is written after from, you write it first and after that you put the subtract symbol, that is the minus. Subtract 2x, that is minus 2x. From 7x. So from 7x subtract 2x. So this is the right term. Again, you take the in the bracket, you write the numerical coefficient 7 minus 2 and multiply the variable. So what you get the result? 7 minus 2, that is 5. 5 into x, that is 5x. So the answer is 5x. That is 7x minus 2x gives you 5x. Okay. Now we do the question number D. Question number D, which says that subtract minus 2xy from 0. Subtract minus 2xy from 0 means how you do? From 0, from the number which is written after from, that is that you write first. From 0 subtract minus 2xy. Subtract sign is minus, and what have to subtract? That you write in the bracket minus 2xy. So here we have to subtract minus 2xy from 0. So that why this minus is for subtraction. And what term here we have to subtract, that is a negative term, minus 2xy. So since the term you are going to subtract is a negative, so always write the negative term in the bracket. We always write the negative term in the bracket. So to minimize the error, in calculation, write always the negative terms in the bracket. Now when you open this bracket, this minus will multiply with this minus, and the product of two minus signs gives you plus. So minus multiply minus gives you plus. So when you multiply minus with minus, you are going to get the result plus. So this minus minus plus, so the answer will be 0 plus 2xy. So when you write 0 and 2xy, you will get the same answer 2xy. There will be no change in the number when you add 0. So 0 plus 2xy gives you 0. Now we go to the last question F. We have to subtract 3 times of x plus y, 3 into x plus y from, this term we have to subtract from, 4 times of x plus y. So we have to subtract this first term, 3 times x plus y, from the term 4 times x plus y. See how we do. So write the term after from, what is written after from, 4 times x plus y, and for the subtract we put minus, and what we have to subtract, 3 times x plus y. Okay. Now you have to multiply this constant term with the given terms in the bracket. So you have to open the bracket. So here when you multiply the 4 with x also and y also. So first you multiply 4 into x plus 4 into y. Here you multiply 3 into x gives you 3x, plus 3 into y gives you 3y. So when you multiply 4 with x, it will give you 4 into x, 4 plus 4 into y, minus, and you have to multiply 3 into x plus y. So whatever the product will come, that you write in the bracket. So here you have written in the bracket 3 into x, 3x, plus 3 into y, 3y. Now see, 4 into x gives you the, when you multiply it will give you 4x. 4 into y is 4y. Now open the bracket, minus plus. So whenever you multiply the minus sign which is each term, with each term in the brackets, it will change the sign of each term. So minus plus minus, that is the minus 3x. And inside the bracket is positive, then minus plus minus will become minus 3y. Now you make a group of the like terms. See, 4x minus 3x gives you x, 1x, and 4y minus 3y gives you y, that is x minus y. So the answer will be x minus y. Now we move to the question number 2. Now we solve question number 2. Question number 2a. Subtract the lower expression from the upper expression. That is written 7a plus 5. This is the upper expression. And 2a plus 1. This is the lower expression. So here subtract the lower expression. This lower expression we have to subtract. So when you are going to subtract the lower expression, so we have to change the sign. So the sign of each term in the lower expression is going to be changed. See how it will be done. Here the sign of the plus 2 is what? Plus. So put a minus. And the sign of this plus 1 is what? Plus. So change it, it will become minus. So okay. So when you are going to subtract, when you are going to subtract the lower expression, at that time we have to change the sign of each term of the lower expression. Now don't consider this plus sign, don't consider this plus sign. Now we have to consider the lower sign which we have written in the bracket. Now 7a minus 2a gives you 5a. Here you see the sign. Plus 5 minus 1 gives you plus 4. So the answer will be 5a plus 4. So the answer is 5a plus 4. Like this we have to do. Now we do question number 2d. Now we will do question 2d. 9x square y minus 11. This is the upper expression, lower expression, minus 2x square y minus 5. So we have to subtract the lower expression. So change the sign of each term of the lower expression. This is minus, so change it, it will become plus. This is minus, this will also become plus. So whenever you subtract the lower expression, so we have to change the sign of the each term of the lower expression. Okay, this we have to do first. Now consider this lower sign of the lower expression. Lower sign which is written in the bracket. Now 9 plus 2, 11. 9 plus 2, 11, x square y. Here minus 11 plus 5. Minus 11 plus 5. That is minus 6. So the answer is 11 x square minus 6. Okay, now we do f. Now 4x square y minus 5x y square. Upper expression, lower expression, 4x square y minus 5x y square. See, we have to subtract the lower expression. Now again change the sign of the each term of the lower expression. So this is plus, now it will become minus. This is minus, it will become plus. So 4x square minus x square y, it will be cancelled. Opposite sign. Now minus 5x y square plus 5x y square, it is also opposite sign, it will be cancelled. So the result will be what? 0. So you are going to get the 0 answer. So here the answer is right, 0. The answer for the 2f is 0. Now we do the question number 3. So the question is, arrange the following columns, arrange the following in columns and subtract. Here we have to arrange in columns. Arrange the following in columns. Arrange the following in columns. And after that we have to subtract. Columns. And subtract. So the expressions which is given, now 3a, we solve 3a. 7p plus 2q. 7p plus 2q plus 5c. This as polynomial we have to subtract from the given polynomial, 9p plus 4q plus 7c. So see in this what we have to do. We have to subtract this polynomial from this polynomial. But this subtraction we have to do in the columns, which we have done in the question number 2. In that form we have to do the subtractions. So write the, here we write the upper polynomial and the lower polynomial, like we have done in the upper expression, lower expression, like we have done in the question number 2. So write the term which is written after from, that in the upper expression. So on the upper expression will be 9p plus 4q plus 7c, this is the upper expression. So what you have to subtract, that will be in the lower expression. So we have to subtract this polynomial, so write in the lower expression. 7p plus 2q plus 5c. Now for subtraction we have to change the sign of the each term of the lower expression. For the subtraction what we do? We change the sign of the each term of the lower expression. So change the sign, which is positive, 7p is positive, so make it negative. 2q is positive, make it negative. 5c is positive, make it negative. Now we have to consider this sign which is written in the bracket. Now we don't consider this sign. So 9p minus 7p gives you what? 2p. So the result is 2p. 2p. 4q minus 2q will be the plus 2q. Plus 7 minus 7 will be the plus 2. Plus 2c. So that is the result. 2p plus 2q plus 2c is the answer of third A. Now we do third C. In third C, see how we do. That I am going to solve it directly. The term what is written, here I am going to write to solve third C. The question is 8x subtract 8x square minus 9x plus 5 from 4x cube minus 3x square plus 7x plus 11. So write the polynomial which is written after from in the upper case, upper expression, 4x cube minus 3x square. See 4x cube minus 3x square plus 7x plus 11. Like this, we can write. Now, the first polynomial write in the lower expression which we have to subtract. So that is the 8x square minus 9x plus 5. 8x square. 8x square minus 9x. 8x square minus 9x plus 5. In the lower expression, one term is not mentioned here, so that is 0. Not mentioned, x cube is not there in the first polynomial, so don't write. So always write the like terms in the same column. First is the column of the x cube. If the x cube term is not written in the polynomial, so don't write anything below the x cube. This is the column of x square term, this is the column of x, and this is the column of constant term. Now we have to subtract this. So we have to change the sign of each term of the lower expression. It is plus, no sign mentioned is plus, so change it, make it minus. It is minus, make it plus. It is plus, make it minus. Now here from 4x cube, nothing is to subtract, so the result will be the 4x cube as it is. No changes will be there. Minus 3 minus 8 gives you minus 11 x square. Now plus 7 plus 9 gives you plus 16 x. Now plus 11 minus 5 gives you plus 6. This is the answer. 4 x cube minus 11 x square plus 16 x plus 6 for C, third C. 9D is what we have to subtract from 0. So from 0 you have to subtract in D. So 0 minus and write in the bracket minus in the column. So there will be, so the upper expression will be 0, upper expression will be the 0, nothing will be there, and you have to subtract. See third D how to do. So upper expression you write 0 and lower expression minus 2p cube plus 7p square. Minus 2p cube plus 7p square minus 20 plus 3p. So minus 20 plus 3p. So there is 4 term in the first expression, 1, 2, 3, 4. So write 4 0 in the upper expression. Now we have to subtract it. So in order to subtract, we change the sign of the each term of the lower expression. This minus will become plus. This plus will become minus. This minus will become plus. This plus will become minus. Okay. Now see. 0 plus 2p cube gives you 2p cube. Here 0 minus 7p gives you minus 7p square. 0 plus 20 gives you plus 20. 0 minus 3p gives you minus 3p. So that is the answer. 2p cube minus 7p square plus 20 minus 3p. Okay, so this is all for the today, students. In the next class, we will solve the remaining question 4, 5, 6 of self practice 5C. So, thank you for your kind attention.